We think in words, we think in pictures, we think in smells, we think in feelings. Like right now you can think about the way that you imagine like a really soft cat would feel if you're petting it. You know, we think in all kinds of modalities. I happened to read a book called Thinking in Pictures by Temple Grandin. Temple Grandin is a well-known person on the autism spectrum, and she does a lot of amazing things with her visual thinking. She designs livestock equipment and visualizes these complicated pieces of machinery all in her mind. And what we see in some other people with autism also is that they seem to be sort of hard over on the visual side. Can we replicate that in our AI systems? And can we use our AI systems to better understand what is actually going on in a person's mind, like Temple Grandin's? So the Raven's Progressive Matrices is a really widely used intelligence test. And the problems look kind of like geometric analogies, where you'd see like one circle going to two circles, and then one square, and then you have to figure out what that missing piece is. And we literally, you know, scan the problems from those test booklets and feed them into our AI systems and see how well our AI systems can do on those same tests. Our best AI system currently does about at the level of an average 16 or 17-year-old. We are impressed and surprised because one of the sort of key features of that particular AI system was that it does all of its reasoning visually. There's a lot of evidence that people actually use sort of images and language when you're solving this test. Like you'll be talking to yourself as you're solving it, and that's part of how, you know, what enables you to deal with the complex problems. We wanted to see how far will images alone take you using only visual thinking. We need AI systems that will sort of draw from this richness of varieties of human intelligence to be more capable and more powerful and more creative.